This is our daily trip to feed and check Lily and the puppies. We're 6 kilometres from the town centre at the Rudozem landfill. This is where they were dumped when the puppies were just a week old. This is the landfill site. We've been told that there's been at least another 18 dogs dumped there. The danger now is that they're growing up wild, probably breeding, without any human contact at all. The little shelter that we've made for the puppies is further along here. This is the closest we've got to having our own dog shelter. It might not meet the EU standards, but at least it's kept these 6 alive.
We've fed many dogs on the streets. We still do now. Some of them have gone missing. There's always more to take the place. Many of them rely on us for the food, and we find that they'll be in a particular place at a particular time. If we didn't feed them, the dogs would simply starve. The children have come home, they tell us that they'd seen dogs that were kicked, hit with sticks, stones. The thing that we found hardest to understand was that people would actually go out of the way to hurt the dogs. It wasn't that the dogs were approaching them and they didn't want them, or that they were scared of them. They were deliberately going out of the way to hurt them. Part of it may be due to the fact that they've been told to carry a disease. We see women with children, if a dog comes anywhere near them, they'll pull the children out of the way. This leads to a fear in the children of the street dogs. For some, it isn't a fear, they just hate the dogs. The majority of the street dogs aren't dangerous. Most of them are absolutely terrified of people. They wouldn't come near people to attack them. We try and approach them, they would run. I went to one isolator after we discovered that Matty, one of our rescue dogs, had spent 6 months in there. The dogs were kept in like small concrete cells. There was nowhere for them to see out. They couldn't see other dogs. They weren't let out for exercise. There was nothing on the floor. The dogs were lay on the concrete. They were hosed down with cold water to clean out the cells, and the dogs were left in the cold and the wet. They were fed with bare bones, and the lady that ran the isolator seemed quite proud to tell me that as an extra treat they would be given a stock cube in some water. The conditions were absolutely horrendous. Ranger was first befriended by Luke, our youngest son. He saw this dog, saw how thin he was, how scared, saw that he had an odd shaped head. One of his friends told him that the dog had been smashed over the head with a brick when it was a puppy. This was because he was owned by somebody, he was thrown out, and they hit the dog to stop it from returning home. We did intend just to keep them as pets. It was only when we realised that there were more and more dogs needing help that we thought we couldn't keep taking in more and more dogs and keeping them all as pets. In 2008, we realised that we did need to do something if we were going to keep taking in more dogs. We then decided to try and start a foundation, maybe get people to help by fostering, sponsoring and adopting the dogs. We decided to start a registered foundation. This finally came through at the beginning of 2009. We have an absolutely fantastic adoption team in Holland. We don't send any of our dogs to other shelters. People are carefully screened and we make sure that we try and get the right dog for the right family. Apart from the dogs that we have here at the house, there are so many more on the streets that desperately need help. We have to walk away from dogs that we feed, that we've become attached to. We never know if we're going to see them again, whether they're going to be killed, shot, kicked. It's an absolute nightmare. We need the shelter so that we can help more dogs, so that we can get more dogs neutered and released, and therefore cut down the number of dogs that are being born on the streets in the first place. The main thing we need help with is fundraising. We need funds so that we can get land, so that we can get a shelter. We also need to raise funds for the transport. Usually we try and arrange transport for adoptions every 2 months. Usually it will take 12 dogs going on a trip to cover the expenses. This isn't always the case. Sometimes maybe 7 or 8 dogs will go. The rest of the money then has to come out of our funds, which would have been used for other things.